In today's video, we'll take a look at how to place video inside text and a few different things we can do with this effect. Hey guys, what's up? My name is Serge and welcome back to my channel. First, we'll take a look at how to place one video inside your title and animate it to scroll across the screen. And in the second part of the video, we'll take a look at how to place different video clips inside each letter of your title. Let's jump right into Final Cut Pro and get started. First, select your video clip and drop it into your timeline. Open your Titles and Generators browser and select the title you want to use for this effect. I recommend using a basic title and customizing it in the text inspector. Grab your title, drag and drop it on top of your video clip in your timeline, and ripple trim it to the length you want. Select your title clip and head up to the text inspector. Enter your text and pick a font to use for your title. You want to pick a font with large, heavy letters, so the one I like to use is Impact. Use a scale slider to increase the size of your title, and if you run out of room on the slider, you can always click the number beside it and go even higher. Make your text as big as you can, but make sure all of it stays on screen. Click and drag the text in the viewer to position it where you want. Now, to place your video inside the text, make sure your title clip is still selected and go to the Video Inspector. Near the top, open the Blend Mode drop-down menu and select Stencil Alpha. This makes your video show through the letters with a black background. For the next step, let's make our letters even bigger and make them scroll across the screen. For this, we'll use a Transform tool. First, let's zoom out on our viewer so we can easily move the text around. Move your playhead to the start of your title clip and make sure it's selected. Hit the Transform button and scale up your clip until the letters take up most of your screen. Next, click and drag your title clip to the right until the letters are just off screen. Add a keyframe here to the Transform parameter. Move your playhead to the end of your clip, and in the viewer, drag your title to the opposite side of the screen. To make sure you move in a straight line, hold down the Shift key while dragging. Click Done. Here's what we have so far. Now, if instead of a black background, you want another video clip or a still image behind your text, there's two ways of doing this. If you simply grab a clip and add it below your timeline, it doesn't show through the black background. To make your video or still image replace the black background, you have to combine your top two clips into a compound clip. Control-click your two clips and press Option-G to combine them into a compound clip. This makes the black background clip transparent and the clip under it is now visible. That's one way of doing this. I'll press Command-Z a few times to undo that. Another way to achieve this is by placing your clip on top and changing its blend mode. Drag your clip down into your timeline and place it above your other clips. Next, with the top clip selected in the video inspector, change the blend mode to behind. This places your top clip behind your other clips, but it's still visible behind the text. As you can see, placing a single video inside text is nice and simple. Next, we'll take a look at how to place different video clips inside each letter, and it's actually not that much harder. Select your video clips you want to use and stack them on top of each other in your timeline. Ripple trim them all to the same length. Place your title above your video clips. Enter your text and change the title's appearance. Same as before, change the blend mode of your title to Stencil Alpha. As you can see, only the top clip shows through the letters. To make the other clips visible, we'll use a combination of the Transform and Trim tools. Select your top clip, click the Transform button, and change the scale and position of your clip until the interesting part of your clip fills the first letter. Next, switch to the Crop tool. Make sure Trim is selected, and trim off the right side of your video clip. Click Done, and select the clip under it. Once again, resize and reposition your clip inside the second letter, and trim off the right side of your clip. Do the same for the next letter in your title. This time, our two letters overlap a bit, and you can see a little part of your next clip inside this letter. Select your Trim tool again, and move the right side back a bit until you can't see the next clip inside this letter. Open your effects browser and select the draw mask. Add this to your clip and in the viewer, add control points to make a rough outline around your letter. And finally, reposition and resize your bottom clip to fit inside your last letter. Here's our finished result. A cool title with a different video clip playing inside each letter. And not that much harder to do than the first example we did. If you enjoyed this video, make sure to let me know in the comments below or by hitting the like button. And if you're new here, check out the rest of my channel for more cool Final Cut Pro tutorials like this one. New videos uploaded every week, so please subscribe. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you back here next week.